Hi, welcome back to Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, starring me, your humble, loyal man, and this tiny little baby who's 100 years old. Where we left off, this little person wanted us to light their furnace thing with some ancient blue fire, which we're now going to go do. So I'm going to need a torch. Luckily, there is one right here. Now that I know what you're thinking. But Daniel, how come there wasn't anything last week? And also, why do you have more hearts, more armor, more weapons? Well, I'll address the most jarring issue right now, being the continuity, in that, like I said previously, if you're tuning in right now, you may not have heard this, but I do believe I have mentioned I'm going to be grinding and doing a lot of stuff off-screen whenever I get the chance, because I don't want this series to go on for, like, 300 parts. I want to say hopefully I can get this done in under 50. That just seems more conducive to everybody, because I don't want to have to fucking be saddled with the obligation of beating this game under, like, 100. That's too much. So, going out of my way, I'm going to go and do a bunch of shrines and stuff. I'm not doing any side quests, so I'm not talking to anybody with red icons above their head. I'm not going to do anything unique, but if it's just a random like shrine in the middle of the world, I'm going to go do it off-screen so I can get the spirit orbs to level up. What the heck? Huh. If there are shrines that I think are particularly noteworthy or cool looking, I'm saving them, and I'm going to do them for you, because I do want to show you the cool stuff in this game, and I do believe a few shrines do need to be shown, because there are some cool ones in the world, but otherwise, stuff like that, side quests, and story stuff will all be shown. I'm not gonna hide, I'm not gonna show, or I'm not gonna not show everything. Do I have arrows? I wonder. Hold on a second. I have one arrow. Make it count. I learned this trick, so there's a puzzle that requires you to do this, and I learned this trick the hard way. But there we go. Boom! Nice. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna jump over here without having to worry about my, my torch going out. Thank you. And we're on the road again. So I gotta get this thing all the way up the hill to there, and there's a pretty good chance. Torches are durable, but they don't last forever, especially when they're on fire, so there's a good chance that this might go out before I make it all the way up, and I might have to go find another wooden object to use. It can be a club, it can be a spear of some sort of wooden make. Anyway, so, as I also stated, I was gone for a week. I was on vacation down in Seattle, Washington. Why did that go out? Seattle, Washington, obviously, being a lot far away from my hometown of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. I was down there to see a concert. And you just hang out, do the thing, see the sights. I don't like being a tourist, but I was, and it was okay, it was nice, it was fun. I went down to see Coheed and Cambria, because they're not coming to Edmonton, because apparently we're not cool enough for them. I don't even think they're coming to Canada on this tour they're doing. Second time seeing them, saw them with Iron Maiden when they came back in, like, 2012. Good show. Nice venue. Seattle is a very strange place to anyone who's not from there. I'm not talking just, like, infrastructure, but just the way the city is. It's a weird city. It's very cool. And, okay, why is the wind? Is the wind blowing the torch out? Because the way this works, if you go torch to torch... Oh, it's raining. Oh, I see how it is. Is that going to put my light out? Yeah, light's fine. Oh. Okay, well, I think I have to go sleep until the weather passes, or at least sit on fire somewhere. That's unfortunate! Yeah, Seattle is a weird city. Like, infrastructurally, it's built on stilts everywhere. And it is like... How do I put this? It's like if the city planner got, like, really drunk and then broke into their kid's room and stole all the Hot Wheels and just started fucking, like, connecting all the Hot Wheels, like, fucking put an overpass here and a curve here, and you gotta exit on the right lane, but then get into the left lane immediately. It's weird. This is not a hotel. Can't sleep in these beds. But what else is in there? Went to Round 1 Arcade, played Tekken 7, which is, this is not the hotel either. Tekken 7 continues to be fun. Still convinced Tekken 7 Fate of Retribution will never come out, as it has been, like, 30 years since it's been announced. Oh, is it stop raining? What the fuck? Pura, the tiny little girl lady up in the tech lab, she did mention how you need to sleep to pass the time to potentially stop the rain from, you know, falling. So it may be, hey, come on, man. Oh, I'm out of stamina. It may be entirely possible that it is gating me from doing this until I sleep in the bed up there. Oh, shit. So so I might have just been wasting your time this whole time, because the rain did stop after me going off and doing a bunch of random miscellaneous things in the world, as it is a persistent world, and time does happen to flow like a regular persistent world. Rain? Let's go. If I can make it to this next torch, I'll consider this a success. Looks clear. Not a cloud, well, a cloud, but it is blue skies, so I think we're on the hook. Off the hook, I don't know. What else is there in Seattle that I did? I went to the Popsai Museum, I went to the Glass Museum, went to the Gardens, went to... We didn't go up to Space Needle, but I went to the Space Needle. This is my second time going to Seattle, and this is my second time not going to the Space Needle, and I don't really want to go up in the Space Needle. It's expensive, and I don't really care for it. But I will mention that I'm pretty sure I saw it this time, too, but the first time I was in Seattle was for PAX 2013, and just wandering around looking for a Taco Bell one time, I walked by the Space Needle grounds just kind of by accident, and there was some sort of music festival going on, whatever, but there was something interesting in that. Is this the right way? Oh, jeez. There was a plane, like a prop plane, flying around the grounds, way off in the distance, like a respectable altitude. I'm not a pilot, so I don't know. But it was towing a banner, and behind the banner, the banner read, "Zoo elephants suffer." And I'm like, oh, okay, all right, that's respect the message, respect what you're trying to say here. Interesting way to do it. And then I'm pretty sure, driving out on like the 5, I saw another one. I don't know. I can't be certain, because if that's two sightings of a plane pulling some sort of strange message, then Seattle's a strange place. It is a really weird place, but I don't know. I don't consider myself that lucky. Either way. God, look at Link. He's like the torchbearer of the Boston Marathon, or some other marathon. The Olympic Marathon. They're all marathons. Marathon this, marathon that. Go, buddy! This part... The world being as big as it is in this game, it kind of sucks for mobility, because you're still a slow, tiny man, and even though in my, like, my main file I have, like, 2 rings of stamina and then some, I can only still run for 10 seconds straight, oh, like, 14 seconds straight, which is, it's not great, it's not the worst thing in the world, but I mean, I just want to be able to run fast. The world's so big, it's so hard to get around, and the horses don't control very well. I'm sorry, Rhubarb 2. Hello! I did it! Hey, me! Thank you so much. Now go look over there. It's a guidance stone. Starting to react. I'm going to go put my iPhone in it. I'm going to get a new app. Snap! You're welcome. Lock removed. Let's do this thing. I can't wait to get the new version of Pinout. Nice. Camera? Oh, that's right. The camera. I'm feigning ignorance of what the camera is, because maybe you don't know. But, like previous Zelda games, Majora's Mask and Wind Waker were the only two that had a camera system, like a take pictures, show people kind of camera. This one has two, but also it has the amazing ability to take selfies, which is what everyone wanted. Some memories. Oh man, some beautiful memories. And the Hyrule Compendium. This is for crazy people. What you do is you take pictures of animals, monsters, equipment, stuff like treasure, and you can take pictures and then kind of log it in the book. And if you're crazy and want to go on a safari, you can try and find every single looking little piece of thing in the world. That's insane. That's too much. There's no way anybody can do that. Which one is it? I'm not showing you anything. What? Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and take a picture of you here. Zoom real in the face. That's not bad. So you can make Link pose for the camera. Just by pointing in a different direction on the stick. She's like, what the fuck is this guy doing? Anyway. What's up? I took one. The vernacular in this game, because you can see on the dialogue options there, I could question what a pic was, of course being a picture, and that's, you know, common in our modern speaking slang society, but, you know, Link, he's a medieval man, maybe he doesn't know what that is. Okay, what do you want? Old landscape photos. Princess Zelda made frequent use of the camera feature, but this, hey Linky, it dawns on me, you're the knight, which means you've probably gone there. So the idea being I can go to the spots of those pictures I have in that album to regain lost memories. Bring back some ancient materials to you or Robbie. As if my joy weren't enough, you could bring us some stuff. I think I actually have the stuff to bring you right now. Something good. So if I bring her some stuff, she can power up my runes, which I think I might have. Let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. I'm game. She can sense her first of all. Snap! So with this, if I take a picture of something and add it to my Hyrule Compendium, I can then use the Sheikah Sense to target it, which makes it good for farming, because certain enemies will drop certain things useful in crafting, or upgrading, or dyeing your clothing. So this is a good way to kind of farm for certain things. Ba-ba-ba-ba, I just wish I didn't do this every single time. Boo-bee-bee-boop, boo-bee-bee-boop, boo-bee-bee-boop. Splooch. Glarp. You like this? I am now the folly guy for Legend of Zelda. I make all the sound effects. Yeah, I do. Head in the direction where the reaction is strongest and you should find what you are looking for. Beep beep boop boop. So that's cool. I think it also improves the range, but that might not be true. Of course, the Sheikah Sensor is the thing I use to find shrines hidden throughout the world, as it does make a nice little annoying beep. There's some hair on my monitor that's really bothering me every time the screen fades to black. Hey, you little guidance stone did the trick. Robbie's like, I need you to find me some goddamn mushrooms. No, upgrade more things. Let's do it. Can I upgrade my remote bomb? I don't have the necessary materials. Stasis. Yes. Don't have the necessary materials. Okay, goodbye then. See you later. Alright, so she told me to go see Impa back in Kakariko Village for talks. So we're gonna go talk to Impa again. I imagine, like, I want to believe that is an incredibly painful process, just being bees! Being dematerialized and then just sending up into the sky like spaghetti. Do you hear this thing going around? That artists are putting spaghetti in their tablet pens? As nibs to draw on their tablets. So I have a drawing tablet, and I'll admit that it's not the best thing in the world, but it gets the job done. I don't use it as much as I'd like to. But the idea being the pens need a little nib to kind of register on the tablet to draw. And nibs are expensive. Well, not expensive, but if you lose them, you gotta buy more. They're not like set in stone. You can, you know, replace them, swap them out as is. So what I mean is, like, people are just taking spaghetti, like, I think uncooked spaghetti noodles, putting them in their tablets, and then scratching their tablets at the hell, like, all the hell. Mm. Hi, buddy! We are done in there. Please, I don't ever want to go back and talk to that strange little child. Whoa, okay, she looked like she was gonna die. Here, take a look at all of these places I've probably been to. Whoa! Oh. That's cool. So she's like, yeah, you go to these places, man, you'll remember things. I'm like, I don't believe that for a second. But I do believe that if you have trouble finding out these places, check this guy out. Sup, homeboy? Now that I have the camera, a bunch of side quests are opening up for me. So I'm going to do this one. So this guy, he's been all over the world as an artist. She's like, I know everything, but what I don't know is what a fairy's fountain is. But we've already been to the fairy's fountain. Wait, have we? I'm pretty sure we have. Dude, you're crazy. You're crazy, man. So he wants to see it. He wants to see the fairy's fountain. Don't you run your fucking head coming for me next. Please. Please run faster, old man. I could scale this rock surface. Oh, no, never mind. I'll go this way. I mean, I could. Because I'm a beast of a man, but I could. You might notice also I'm wearing this armor. This armor in an upgraded state is what I'm wearing in my other file. It is the currently the most easily available high-end armor for defense. as well as this bandana. Because again, the bandana, improving climb speeds, you just, I want to move faster in this giant world because they're so slow. Everything's so slow in The Legend of Zelda, The Breath of the Wild. Right, dude? Wah, wah, wah. Oh, you know what? I left a thing behind in the... Oh, come on, hurry up. Cool, cool. Nice. What? Whoops. I left a thing behind in the ancient tech lab that I probably wanted to pick up. Oh well. Okay. Where is he? Where the fuck is he? There should be a bloopy around here somewhere. The bloopy being that little stupid blue thing that I shot for rupees. I'm pretty sure I did that before. My guy? Oh, what happened? Hello? What's up? Oh, you poor man. If only you had a picture! Well, I got something for you, fucking guy. So, the cool thing is, the field of view when you zoom all the way out isn't that bad, and you can kind of run around in first person, which is kind of neat. It's like, what? Well, it's like Pokemon Snap. So technically, I could just take a picture of this and show it to him. He'd be fine with that. So long as it shows you the little thing. Well, yeah. So, I'm not compelled to take pictures of everything that I see, but at the same time, I probably should. Dude, you're so close. You could have just come over this little, over the hill. Get it, because it's old. You could have, man, but you chose not to because you're a putz. Where'd he go? Ho! Oh. Check this out. I did. Yeah, here's a picture. 5 feet away. Wow. You know what? I'm really glad you helped me out here. You know what I will do? I'm going to show you everything you've ever wanted to know. So what you do, you show him your this, and he's like, oh, you know what? I know where that is. And he's around the world. Every stable you go to in the world, he will be there. And he will be like, listen, you want to know where this thing is? Let me tell you. I'll show you exactly where that is. And you may come across these places just randomly in your adventures. Some of the places are easy enough to find that it's just like, wow. Wow, but easiest way, if you want to, listen to him. He'll tell you a general area, mark it on your map, and go there. So he just told me this place, we're gonna go there. Okay, I don't need this anymore. Whoa. Actually, I should check in to see what I need to upgrade my armor, and maybe I have it. Hello again! It's me. Yes, let's do it. Oh, you don't have anything to enhance? Yeah, let's take a look, though. I just want to make sure. Okay, I need chew jelly and Bokoblin guts. Okay. Well then, I guess that's just what's gonna have to happen. Bye. Goodbye. That's nice. That's pleasant. Always good to check in. What? Oh, eggs. Bird eggs. Oh, an elk. Wow. Driving on the highway up to and from Washington, I saw a lot of wildlife on the road, specifically driving through Jasper National Park. But, have I done this one? I have not. Oh, I have. Am I going the right way? I am. Whee! Let's go, let's pick up speed. Yeah, I see a lot of wildlife just on the roads, and luckily we didn't get fucking destroyed by anything. But I will say, so you may know anything about Canada geography, you may know. Oh, you poor guy. Oh well. You may know some that BC, British Columbia, was on fire for a lot of the recent years. Just a bad time in general for anyone in BC. So we drove through areas that were decimated by the fire, and it was pretty breathtaking, I gotta say. But on the way back, some snow fell, some really harsh snow. Like, the roads were absolutely destroyed, like, decimated. Which was pretty cool. What? But going through this area that's totally, like, burned to crisp. Oh, I'm at the wrong place, aren't I? Is it this one? I think it might be this one. Let's take a look at that album. Yeah, no, I'm the wrong place. This place was burned to a crisp but covered in snow. It was pretty cool. An interesting kind of dichotomy. The juxtaposition of the scene was quite striking, if you will. Alright, I'll bite. What's your problem? Oh, your name's Traveler, huh? That's unfortunate. A shimmering object, floating head. Sounds like you were abducted by aliens. Bed full of liquid in an empty corner of the room. Glowing weird device. I attached the device. Sounds awfully familiar. Why so mum, Hylian champion? That's rude. What's a mum? I don't understand. You weird people talk weird. Alright, fucking guy. Let's hit it. Let's go. Whoa. Bop, bop. Whoops. Is that a teleport? There he is. Ha, ha, ho. Three hits? Oh, you poor little baby man. Though. So, of course, in the process of grinding out shrines and everything, I did get a few items, particularly some high-end weapons. For example, this fucking thing, or maybe this goddamn thing. And it was never my intention to go that hard, but I realized in the process of doing some of these shrines, particularly the tests of strength, it just kind of happens that way. Okay, climby climb. Oh god, didn't mean to do that. We're good. Did any of those materials fall this way? Oh, it's just flint and rock salt. God damn it. And I will climb. Get up there. Ooh, opal. That's nice. Whoa. Oh, can't jump and do that. Totally forgot. Nice, what do we got? Flint isn't even worth it. But we do have a flower here. Hello, little flower. Hello, little flower. Where'd he go? Oh, I see it. Oh, I don't have enough stamina for this. Uh-oh. So, for a very specific reason, all of these sporbs I'm getting will be going specifically to, go get it! Yes! We'll be going towards hearts and not stamina for the meantime. And I know I complain a lot about how little stamina I have or how much I just can't run anywhere, but it'll all make sense in due time. What the fuck is this guy? Oh, you know what? Yeah, that makes a good point. That does. So we're just gonna go over here for a second. Special bows fire multiple arrows, but don't waste any ammo. You can take a peek at things. I'm playing on a new Nintendo Switch Pro controller provided by Willy. It's nice. It's actually surprisingly nice. It's got like a weird... So it's a weird mix of a PlayStation 4 and an Xbox One controller in that the shape is kind of reminiscent of a PlayStation 4 with how it's two handles and a flat body. But the stick configuration and the buttons are similar to an Xbox One, which I prefer. Having the two sticks down on the bottom is wrong to me. Well, not wrong. It's objectively different, that's for sure. But it just feels strange. Whereas having the left stick higher up and the D-pad down on par with the right stick is where I prefer them to be. So the fact that it's raining means it's going to be very difficult for me to scale walls. Which... Oh god, no! So I gotta be careful about how I traverse this, and I also don't have enough stamina to run across. But if I kind of jump in on this guy here, oh, there's a lot of them. This might have been a bad idea. Oh, but I can understand that there's a thing I can do right here. Whoops. You're welcome. Bye-bye. Oh, not you. Wait, where the? Oh. So picking the Korok rock up. Whoop, made him de-aggro for a second, but not long enough! Swim! Oh god. Luckily, I don't think any of them have bows, which is gonna help me out. Oh, I gotta get up there. This is not gonna work. This is way up. Oh, there's a chest here, though. Lucky me. My younger brother has been streaming Ocarina of Time speedruns lately. He's getting pretty good. He's got it down, Pat. He can do the warp all the way to Ganon and everything. He's got it down. He's got mods and everything, which is fucking weird. I don't have mods on my stream. Mods being like moderators of the stream, not like game mods, obviously. Oh, rain, please go away. Camera, please stop fucking up. Ooh, he was following me. You know, this might be a good opportunity to... No, not that one. Put that one away. What are you looking at there, you dumby? Okay. Oh, no. Stop raining? No, it's still raining. I gotta get up this wall. But how? Oh, there's a boat over there that I could sail. Maybe go all the way down. Is this a river? Is this flowing like a river? No, this looks like a basin of some kind. Well, what can you do? Try my odds. Shouldn't have jumped there. Oh, you know what? Because I'm... Oh, no, never mind. Doesn't work that way. Ah, you poor little guy. I'm not gaining any ground doing that either. And if I fall in the water, that'll just straight up kill me. Oh, wait, I can do this here, though. This is easy. Come on. Oh, that's not a... There we go. Get your stamina back. Climby. Ho. Good. Okay, this is a good staging area. I can work with this. We'll just keep climbing the wall. I'm sure the ability to climb any surface at a whim does offer for some strange pathfinding. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Oh, why am I such a dumbo? But the ability to climb any wall probably adds some pathfinding issues that the game was never intended for. But again, that's the beauty of this strange Zelda mishmash, is that you really do have a lot of choice in how you give me your frog and how you tackle certain things. Which is nice. What is this? A glow-in-the-dark snail. Disgusting. Am I going the right way? Yes, I am. What was I going to say? But, like, this whole area, you think about this, and, oh, good, a blood moon. I don't know if this was demonstrated before, but guess what you're gonna get to go and look at? I'm not gonna bother killing these guys, because you'll see in a minute why that's not a good idea. Just keep going, just keep... Oh, wait, I need your guts. Hold on a second. We need Midnight to come real quick so I can kill you and take your guts. Come on, there we go. So here's what's up. Certain nights around midnight, a thing called the blood moon will arise. And what it does is it's excuse for respawning enemies to make sure that, you know, things are finite in the world, or infinite in the world, rather. Because in a game where resource management is a thing, where you have to keep track of, you know, what you have, what kind of materials you have, what you're using your materials for the ability for them to run out and be finite would be horrible in this video game. So luckily for us. Don't know why I'm wasting so many weapons on these guys. This blood moon thing comes around and basically brings back every single enemy that spawned that you killed. So you can then just do it all over again. And encounters like camps, certain things like that will always come back. So you chests even, the stuff that are in the chest will come back for you to use. Can I take this club? Thank you. I can't throw the shield, can I? Thank you. So it's a good little in-universe excuse to have all the enemies just come back consistently, which is nice. I only got one pair of guts from those guys, though, so maybe it wasn't worth it. What's this? Oh, that's a big boy. That's a blue moblin. I don't mean to be taking these pictures, but I just feel like I can now that I have it. Undo that. Oh, he's awake. Step into... Oh, can't do it yet! Okay, you just missed. No big deal. Keep on going. Keep on attacking. You missed again, buddy. Followed. Oh, I don't think I've killed a moblin yet. That was a moblin. They look different in every game. This guy wasn't too bad, though. Alright, just gonna go ahead and... Oh, jeez. Oh, boy. Oh, come on. There we go. That. This. They do a lot of damage, which is why my shield was worn down so quickly. We're almost there. Is that an ore deposit? I feel like that is an ore deposit. That is an ore deposit. Okay, I definitely want to take a picture of this. Because for money farming, I need to know where these things are. Thank you. Particularly the ones that have the glowing goldy bits on them, because those ones have specifically diamonds and topaz, emeralds. Oh, amber, that's the good one. Please don't slide away. You know, stuff that makes you the money. There's a quest in the game later on to gather 10 diamonds for somebody, because she'll buy them at a higher price, which doesn't seem very conducive to anything, but she's like, yeah, I'll do it. Yay! Okay, I'm going to shut up for a second. Well, bottom line, though, because like she's like, you can sell all these diamonds, 10 diamonds for 5,000 rupees, but I'll buy them for 5,500 rupees. I'm like, okay, if you got the money, man. Anyway, so going to each of these places will trigger a cutscene of Link regaining his memory, and then a cutscene of them with Zelda. Just kind of talking, hanging out. Because you can do them in any order, there really is no continuity to them. Well, I'm sure there is, but because you do them in order, you get it out of order. So let's see what Link remembers here.
Well, don't keep us in suspense. How'd everything go up there on the mountain?
So you didn't feel anything? No power at all?
I'm sorry, no.
Then let's move on. You've done all you could. Feeling sorry for yourself won't be of any help. After all, it's not like your last shot was up there on Mount Lineru. Anything could finally spark the power to seal Ganon away. We just have to keep looking for that thing.
Link looked really weird in that shot. I think whenever they try to rig his face to show any kind of emotion, he looks kind of weird.
I'm not sure how to put this into words. I'm actually quite embarrassed to say it. But I was thinking about what I do when I'm healing. You know, what usually goes through my mind. It helps when I think about.
Oh gosh. The set of the Star Trek Enterprise is shaking again. I mentioned it before, but I love how long the thing's mouth is.
Are you sure?
It just looks wrong, and that's cool. Oh gosh.
Let's stop wasting time. We're gonna need everything we got to take that thing down. Now, champions, to your divine beasts, show that swirling swine who's boss. Link will need to meet Ganon head on when we attack. This needs to be a unified assault. Little guy, you get to Hyrule Castle. You can count on us for support, but it's up to you to pound down.
I like Daruk. He's cool. He's a nice guy. He's a big nice guy.
We should go. We need to get you someplace safe.
No. I'm not a child anymore. I may not be much use on the battlefield, but there must. There must be something I can do to help.
That's pretty dire and ominous, honestly. For the first memory Link gets, he's like, whoa, things were fucked up when I went to sleep. So now I can go into my album and review that memory anytime I want. Anyway, that's gonna do it for this time around. Glad we could cap it off with something important. We'll see y'all again next time. Have a good evening. Drive safe. Please phone your dad. Call your mom. They miss you. Goodbye.